Here's a way on how you can use your fingers in a different manner. We are going to use a tremolo. A tremolo is a movement of four sounds, which would be the thumb, the annular, the middle, and the index. And utilizing or using the same scale that we have been looking at, you can improve your playing. For example, we are going to take the C chord. And we are going to use the same finger one in the C chord, and we are going to play the tremolo. The thumb playing the second string, the annular play the first string, the middle, and the index. It's going to go like this. So let's check out how do we do that. So we use the same scale that we have been using, and these are thirds. Thirds because the first note is a C, the third note is going to be an E. So one, the second, one, that's it, the second, and the third. So the first, the second, and the third. So if we go to the next step, so it'll be a D, an E, and an F. So D is the first, E is the second, F is the third. If we continue on, so now we have E, F, and G. So E is the first, F is the second, and G is the third. And same on and on and on. So we have. And we're going to work our way back. And then we can continue on. So the trick is maintain your fingers rotating all the time. So B A M I B A M I B A M I. All these exercises are in my book that I wrote that is called Training Your Right Hand. That you can let me know if you want to get a copy of that by sending me an email to angelfargas@yahoo.com, and then I can send you maybe a copy through email or PDF or a hard copy, whatever you prefer. So you have the movement. This movement you can also transfer to other strings. For example, in the same C chord, we can use the fourth and the third string. of you practicing and playing a little bit more like using your fingers and trying to make it happen. So all the time, this is like kind of my daily exercises that I use all the time. All the time I'm doing. I can use this one in a different song, for example. Same tremolo. Practice slowly, and then it will happen. Slowly, what I say will be about this speed. And then move to the next. And when you control that one, move again. Look, notice that I'm moving the same shape forward. I'm going to change the finger 2 and 3. I'm going to move the same shape forward. So it'll be like about 2 of them for each one. So there is a 1 and a 2 and then change. And then I'm going to go back. That's a 1, a 2. Now it's time to change. And the same move, the same thing. And then it's time to change. So you gotta keep that in your back of your mind. And again, change. Here comes the tricky part where you have to change string. You gotta change string again. I'm gonna change string again. And sometimes you have to readjust because you don't get the right place. So you readjust, but you don't stop your right hand, okay?